Hey YouTubers, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's Kojojori from the Jori Dachi, and in today's video, we'll be looking at taking out blemishes, so blemish removal, right? So I've had a couple of requests where people ask me that, come on, my blemish removal is like on point. You don't really see the difference when there's a blemish and when there's not. So I use two tools in Photoshop whenever I'm taking out my blemishes. Or there are three tools you can use: the healing brush tool, the patch tool, and the clone stamp tool. So if you guys have been with me for quite some time, I have a video on blemish removal where I spoke down on the clone stamp tool, and I was like, fine, the healing brush tool was the best. So as time went on and upon learning new things, I realized the clone stamp tool helps a lot, and the healing brush tool, I think, was the best for me, and it's still the best for me. But the clone stamp tool is kind of trying to challenge my healing brush tool. And with the patch tool, I don't use patch tools when I'm editing images as close as these or this or any other close-up image I edit. So let's deal with the healing brush tool. I'll explain the healing brush tool and I'll explain the clone stamp tool. Then we'll see which one works best for you. So always duplicate or always create a new layer from your background so that you work non-destructively. Whenever I make a mistake, I can just delete this and go back to this and duplicate my background layer so that I can work on it. So pick your healing brush tool. Your sampling should be current and below, nothing else. Make sure it's a soft brush, right? The spacing, leave it at 25. If you want more spacing, you can send it to 30 and above, but always make sure it's a soft brush on the healing. I open it up a little bit. So depending on the blemish I want to remove, that's the size I'll open up the brush to. So looking at this, this is bigger than the blemish. So I sample closer to it, then I clean. All right, sample close, clean, sample close, clean, then before and after. So I don't really take out anything over there. It doesn't really take out my textures. It keeps my textures as clean as possible, and it retains them a lot of times for me, but not always. So since the healing brush tool, what it does is more of content aware. So I don't know if you guys have an idea about content aware. What the healing brush does is a small scale content aware. That is what the healing brush tool does. So let's do a quick before and after. Before and after. So you don't see traces of the blemish I took off, right? You just see skin and you become out. So increase the pick. Yes, increase the brush size this way. Then I clean, then I clean. Right. So that is it when you want to use the healing brush. All right, so let's just keep it at this before and after, before and after. One reason why I love the healing brush, it doesn't really leave traces, like I said earlier, right? So it's just skin and skin work. That's if you do it correctly. So to every image, when you want to retouch, kindly concentrate on your blemish removal. Your blemish removal is almost, I think, 40% of a good retouch, right? So of a good retouched image, 40% majority is that of blemish removal. So this is healing with what? Healing brush. So let's just rename this to healing brush. Right, let me hide this, stamp this, because we did a correction there. So if you're looking at, if you're wondering where this correction is coming from, kindly watch my previous video on color correction in Photoshop, then you would understand where this correction is coming from. So I think I'll put up a link, or I'll put up a suggest card at the top, then just tap on it, watch how to color correct your images in Photoshop. So let's clone stamp. So with clone stamp 2, have in mind that it should be current layer. If you're working on, let's say, a new layer, if you're working on a new layer this way, then your sample should be current and below. But if you have duplicated your layer, it should just be current layer, because you might have problems when you're, I think for those who use frequency separation, when you want to use the clone stamp to on the high frequency pass, you might have problems when it's on current and below or all layers. So it should be on current layer to avoid all the stress. So on the clone layer, I'll pick up my clone stamp to make sure my hardness is at zero and my flow, I send my flow to 20. So non-destructive way of using a clone stamp to take out blemishes. It's this way. So look at this. When I sample, right, I sample this side and I want to clear this. This is what happens. So this is the before and after. Let me turn this with the healing brush. This is what the healing brush does. Before and after. With the clone stamp too, this is what it does. Before. So this was the before and this was the after. The only problem with the clone stamp too, I think, is the matter of keeping your textures. So if I apply it more, I think I'll retain my textures. But if I'm looking at blurring out the blemish, just do this. And it takes away, I think, a little bit of my texture. But it's very good if you apply more and more of the cleansing. So it's almost a direct copy of where you are sampling. So make sure to sample very good side and use that to clean your blemish. So let's do a quick before and after. Before and after. Before and after. So let's concentrate here, right? Before the clone stamp two, after the clone stamp two. This is before the healing brush and after the healing brush. So which one do you think did the job better? The clone stamp 2 or the healing brush 2? So always keep in mind, before we end this video, always keep in mind, when you're using a clone stamp 2, use a flow of 20 and below, right? Keep your brush as soft as possible. Then use that in clearing or in cleansing your blemishes. If you're looking at lighting issues concerning wherever it is you sample and you cleanse, you can fix that using dodging and bending or corrective ways in frequency separation. So I think that's it. That's all I have for you guys using clone stamp 2 and healing brush to take out blemishes of your images in Photoshop. So yeah, if you like this content, kindly smash the like button, leave a comment down in the description below. Let me know what you thought about this video after watching it, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.